Creating beautiful cinematic color aesthetics does not need to be difficult. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this golden cinematic Kodak 2383 look. And I'm going to show you how to do this in only 4 nodes. The footage that we're going to work with today is from artlist.io. If you have Artlist and you are interested in downloading this footage, I'll leave a link to that in the description. And if you don't have Artlist and are interested in getting Artlist, I have a link for you that you can use to get 2 months for free. If you're a colorist or a filmmaker, Artlist is an extremely valuable asset to have because it's a giant, endless library of music, sound effects, footage, graphic templates, and more. And it's a great site if you're a colorist because you have access to endless amounts of footage in pretty much every RAW or log profile that there is out there. Every day they upload new footage, and it's been an amazing tool for me to use and to be able to color grade every day. I am an artist as well, and I do art on the side. As a sketch artist, you pretty much have access to a paper and pencil always. But as a color grade artist, you don't always have access to high quality footage. It is an affiliate link, so if you sign up through that link, you are helping out this channel. So thank you for that. And this clip that we're gonna be using was shot on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K Pro, and we are gonna use the original RAW format of this footage. So we're back in Resolve. Let's go ahead and set up our node tree. So I'm going to take this first node and rename it IDT. And this will be where we transform our RAW image into DaVinci wide gamut. And we are working with a RAW file. So to check the color space and gamma information, we can come over here to the camera RAW panel. We can see here the settings that were used in camera when taking this shot. For Blackmagic design footage, it's sort of become a mess of a bunch of different profiles. And so whenever I get a RAW clip that's from a Blackmagic camera, I just set it to DaVinci wide gamut, just to keep things a lot easier, straightforward. And so this is pretty pointless, but I just wanted to show you the process. In case you're working with RAW footage that's from a different camera, you would go ahead and take this color space and gamma information and put it here in the input color space and input gamma. After that, I'm gonna create another node. I'm gonna hold down Option, click and drag this node to copy over the color space transform effect. And now I'm gonna set my output color space and output gamma to my display settings. So I do Rec. 709 and Rec. 709A because I am on a Mac. And now we have our DaVinci wide gamut working space ready for us to start making adjustments. So I'm gonna add 3 nodes. This first node will be our primaries. Second node will be our windows, power windows. And this third node is where we're going to adjust our look. And I'll actually add one more node, and this is where we will add our LUT. So there you go. We're gonna create this look with basically 4 nodes, okay? First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into the LUT node and I'm gonna add in my Kodak 2383 D55 LUT from my K83 LUT pack. If you are interested in getting this LUT pack, there's a link to it in the description of this video as well. If you do not have this LUT pack, no worries at all. You can use the LUT that's built into DaVinci Resolve. And this is how you would set it up. Oh, I actually forgot to rename this. So let's go over to the ODT node. I'm gonna hold down Command, click and drag with the LUT node, and that's gonna switch them around. So now we have the LUT node after the ODT. So in the ODT node, we're gonna go to Output Gamma, and we're gonna set it to Cineon Film Log. And then in the LUT, we're going to choose the Kodak 2383 D55 Rec. 709 LUT. My LUT is a little different from the DaVinci Resolve LUT. It is based on the DaVinci Resolve LUT, but it's been improved to reproduce colors a little better, as well as work well with neon lights and problematic areas like that. I do like my LUT, so I'm going to work with my LUT here. So now that we've got our LUT going on, here's our image before, and this is our shot with the LUT. So let's go into our primaries. In your primaries, you're adjusting your exposure and your white balance. Typically, the color space transform tool gives you a good amount of saturation. So whenever I adjust saturation, I always end up doing that later on in my look node. I almost never do it in my primaries node. That doesn't mean you have to do it that way. You can definitely adjust your saturation here in the primaries. Okay, so in my primaries, I'm gonna think like an artist. I'm gonna take the exposure and I'm gonna bring it down by perhaps a little bit more than I should. So let me see here. 1 stop, 2 stops. I'm gonna bring it down by 1.5 stops. And the reason I'm gonna do this, I know that in this node, I'm gonna use power windows to bring out my subject in a way that's gonna add some depth to the image. Something else I'll do here in my primaries is go over to my vectorscope, and then I'm using the printer light buttons on my MacBook touch bar, which control the offset wheel. So if I add some yellow, you can see that the offset wheel moves towards yellow. Okay. The image is looking a little cyan, so I'm just going to reduce some, just a little bit. And that's good there. Just a very quick, simple adjustment. So as far as saturation, I like where it's at, so I'm not going to touch that here. Now I'm going to go into my power windows. And I'm going to grab a circular power window. I'll zoom out. I'll make this nice and wide. And I'll feather it out. Then I'm going to select Shift H so I can see my selection. And then I'm just going to scrub through and make sure that the selection is staying on our subjects throughout the whole shot. Yeah, that's fine there. So now that I've done that, I'm going to go to my HDR wheels. If you saw my previous tutorial, you know exactly what I'm doing. It's the same technique. If you want to see a more in-depth explanation to this technique, you can go ahead and watch that. I've created my power window. Now I'm going to check my selections in the HDR panel. And it looks like the shadow wheel is the one I want to use. I'm going to bump that up by, let's say, 2/3 of a step. Maybe 1/3. Perfect. I'm going to drag down my Windows node, right click, go to add node, and then add outside node. And now this is going to give us a node that's going to affect everything on the outside of this selection. So I'll go over to my HDR wheels to check out my selection. And then I'm going to bring it down by one stop to see what happens. Check my waveform too. That's not too bad. I'm going to bring it down by 2/3 of the stop. That's good there. And that's giving us a nice sort of vignette effect down here. And then I might actually also do the sky. Yes, perfect. I'm going to bring down the sky as well. Actually, I might not do it that much. That's good there. If we take a look at our image before and after, we can see we're relighting the scene and using the combination of power windows as well as using the luminance selections that the HDR wheels create automatically, we create a very natural looking relighting of the scene. Now let's go over to our look node. This LUT is doing a lot of the work for us already. If I were to take this off, we can see what our image looks like just with our primaries adjustment and those windows adjustments. So we're using the Kodak 2383 color to help us get there. So to create this golden look, I'm going to go into my look node, and all I'm going to do is take my gamma and push it towards yellow. I'm also going to switch over to my vectorscope so I can see everything that's going on with my color. And I'm just going to push it over towards yellow. Okay. And that's good for now. Here is before and after. You can see our sky gets that nice golden yellow color applied to it. Our foliage becomes warmer, and this is looking good so far. We have an analogous color scheme going on. An analogous color scheme is basically the colors in your image are next to each other on the color wheel. So we have our skin tones, which are right here, this orange. We have some yellows, which is, you know, these highlights here in the foliage. And we have some green color, which is all the main body of the foliage. And what we want to do is widen it a little bit. So we want to create some color separation, okay? And adding color separation to your looks can really go far in making your look pop. So this is how we're going to do that. So with this look adjustment, we've taken our entire color palette and we've pushed it over here. Yes, and it's sort of aiming towards this line here. So to create some color separation, I want to widen it out this way and this way. And here's how we're going to do that. We're going to add green and we're going to add magenta, and we're going to keep it very subtle. So we're going to go over to our curves. We're going to go over to our green curves, and that controls the green and magenta axis. We push this up, it adds green. We push this down, it adds magenta. And here's how we're going to do it. We're going to go over to the sky, and we're going to add our anchor, and we're going to go over to the shadows. We're going to add another anchor. Now for the highlights, I want to add a little bit of green. So I'm going to take this control here and push it up just a tiny bit. Really not a lot. is I want this to be subtle. Now I'm going to go over to my other anchor and I'm going to bring it down to add magenta to the image. And if you look over at the vectorscope, our fan here is still pointed in the same sort of direction, but now it's just being widened a little bit. Let me add a little bit more green. Not so much. And there you go. So now this is what our look is looking like. I might even go back to the gamma wheel and push a little bit more towards yellow. And even up towards red, just a tiny bit. And I feel like our shadows are looking a little too green, so I'm going to go back to these curves. I'm going to add a little bit more magenta. There you go. And here's our look before and after. One more thing that is a good practice, specifically with cinematic looks, because it helps to create this saturation compression effect, is come over here to your saturation versus saturation curve and take the anchor on the far right and bring it down. This anchor on the right is affecting the most saturated parts of your image, and it's just helping to take them down and create this nice taper into the least saturated parts of your image. And if I hit a before and after it, you can see that it's just knocking off the top end of our saturation. And that's helping actually to, if I zoom in here, the skin tones on our subjects are a little oversaturated, so it's just helping to take them down just a little bit. And actually, if we wanted to go a little farther, we could create another anchor, bring it down, and then start to slide it to the left until you feel like you're at a place that you like. I'll zoom out here. I'm actually liking this right here. I think this is okay. One more thing, we can affect our contrast here in the look mode. And I like to use the contrast a lot of the time in the HDR panel, because the contrast here does not affect our colors. So you see, if I take the saturation out all the way, you can see that we still have our color there. If I were to increase the contrast here in the primaries panel, that is removing the color as well. So I'm going to go to my HDR panel and increase the contrast there. Also go over to my waveform. And I'm liking that right there. That's how easy it can be to create nice looking cinematic color. It doesn't need to be that complicated. It can be, but it doesn't need to be. Make use of LUTs, because LUTs that are technically and aesthetically sound can be your best friends when color grading, because they will save you so much time and do a lot of the work for you if you use them correctly. So let me know in the comments if you have any questions. Let me know if there's a specific look that you want to see me create. Again, the links to Artlist and my LUT packs are in the description of this video. That's it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching.